What's going on, everybody? Dato Doya here with another Dragon Ball FighterZ video, this time going over 5 tips that'll help you out in the ranked ladder. Now remember, these tips are only to help you out in the beginning. Once you get high enough on the ladder, people are going to start playing at a level in which you need to react to what they're doing specifically, instead of having a pre-thought-out plan. That's fine though, because if you start by implementing these tips, you'll gradually get better at the game as you play more. Alright, so let's start with the mental attitude one first. Now this obviously has no effect on your skill in the game, but you have to be mentally okay with losing. I won't go on for too long about this, but it's the fastest way to learn, and if you're angry, you're only going to lose more. Alright, with that out of the way, let's get to the actual in-game tips. The number one thing that most people do wrong that costs them the game is not managing their blue health correctly. If you see one of your characters with a large amount of blue health, switch out so that they can heal it over time. In a 3v3 game like this, every character is important, and you want them to be as healthy as possible. And by chance if they get knocked out early, your chances of winning drastically fall. So you want to make sure you keep as many people alive as possible. And to do that, you have to manage your blue health by switching out often. Be careful though, because an obvious switch-in could lead to an easy down-H combo for your opponent. Now losing characters doesn't inherently mean that you've lost the game. In fact, there are some comeback mechanics in this game designed to help you get back from a bad start. One of these being your Sparking Blast ability. To perform a Sparking Blast, you have to hit RB and RT at the same time, or all 4 face buttons. Sparking Blast gets stronger depending on how many characters you have alive. If you have 3, Sparking Blast will only last a short period and won't do as much. 2 characters left, and it'll last a little longer, but still not as long as if you only had 1 character left. Obviously, if you want the most out of Sparking Blast, you should use it for your last character. But there are situations where that's not a good idea either. Let's say you have 2 characters alive. The one that you're not playing with currently has a little bit of health left, but he has no blue health at all. The one you're playing with is running low on health but has a lot of blue health. I would recommend popping the Sparking Blast in a combo as soon as you land a hit with that character, because the power of Sparking Blast comes from the ability to heal blue health instantly. But if your last character has no blue health left to heal, chances are he'll get knocked out with a stray hit anyway. And speaking of getting knocked out by stray hits, the third tip is to remember to play good defense and offense. Now, I'm not asking you to spend hours in training mode learning how to guard and punish numerous moves, but I am asking you to pay attention and block lows with down back and block overheads with just back on your control stick. Remember, good defense is a mix of reacting and being proactive. Knowing what your opponent's going to try to hit you with makes defense a lot easier. Speaking of that, the fourth tip is to watch what your opponent is doing in the match. See what he likes to do whenever he calls a new character in. Exploiting your opponent's bad habits is the fastest way to win a match. If you notice they can't block lows, start every one of your combos off with a low. If you notice they can't block overheads, try jumping over them and hitting them with a cross-up. Experiment with these things and see what you can do against different opponents. Another way to handle these opponents also plays into tip number 5, which is knowing how to make use of your assist. Now, it shouldn't take too long in training mode. Just go in there and take your favorite team and call in your assist and see what they do. Is it a beam? Is it an overhead? Or do you think it could be used for combo extension? Play around with it and see if you can work it into any combos or block strings. Using your assist is something not a lot of people are doing right now, so if you make the effort to start using them, you're going to see a huge increase in the amount of ranked games you win. But that's about all the tips I can think of to get you started off in ranked modes. Remember to have some fun while you're playing in ranked, and let me know if you've had any success in the ranked ladders down in the comments. I'll be down there as always. And while you're down there, if you enjoyed the video and channel, make sure you click like and subscribe to the channel. I greatly appreciate it. I'm Dato Doya, and I'll see you in the next one.